إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له. Whoever Allah guides, no one can misguide. ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن ربك يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء ويقدر إنه كان بعباده خبيرا بصيرا. The ayah which I've just recited, you'll find it inshallah in Surah Al-Isra. Sometimes it is known as Surah Bani Israel for those who read the Urdu print. You will find it at the beginning of Juz 15, and it is Surah 17. And the ayah is number 30. Inshallah, we say this thing so that when you go home, inshallah, you can look it up. And it translates as follows. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Truly, your Lord extends or expands provision for those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, as He expands provision for some people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may restrict it for a particular person during sometimes for even one person. Allah during a period of time expands His provision, meaning His rizq. And other times it is restricted, and there are reasons for that which we will share together inshallah. إنه كان بعباده خبيرا بصيرا. Truly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows His slaves, knows every little detail of His slave. خبيرا, knows him absolutely 100%. بصيرا, بصيرا means Allah can see what? Can see that slave, can see the action that the slave is doing, and can see whether the action that a person, a believer or a non-believer, deserves the expansion of his provision or the opposite. خبير بصير بمن يستحق الغنى ومن يستحق الفقر. Is knows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he can see who will be best becoming rich, and who will behave better if his provision is restricted. As sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the famous hadith Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said, inna min ibadi man la yuslihu illa al-faqr. Some of my slaves, Allah knows, we said khabir, some of my slaves will not be rectified with anything other than poverty. وَلَوْ أَغْنَيْتُهُ لَأَفْسَدْتُ عَلَيْهِ دِينَهُ. And if I make him rich, rich meaning what? Rich is comparative, meaning richer than what he is now. If Allah expands the rizq of that person and makes him richer, that person will not be doing the actions that he is currently doing in terms of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَأَفْسَدْتُ عَلَيْهِ دِينَهُ. That there will be something wrong with his religion. And the opposite is true. وَإِنَّ مِنْ عِبَادِي مَنْ لَا يُصْلِحُ إِلَّا الْغِنَى. Hadith Qudsi continues. And some of my slaves, they will only be rectified if they have more wealth. Life is easy for them. There are a type of people, if life becomes difficult, his worship becomes less, because he is concerned and he is worried, and there is a characteristic like that. Some becomes a concern, and actually his acts of worship becomes less. This is Allah knowing what will be best for every person. وَلَوْ أَفْقَرْتُهُ لَأَفْسَدْتُ عَلَيْهِ دِينَهُ. And Allah saying, and if I make that person poorer than the state that he is in now, his practice of deen effectively will be less for him. In other words, Allah is gives every person what suits him, so that he is closer to practicing his religion in the best possible way. It's now our choice whether we do that or not. That's a different matter. وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. In Surah Al-Baqarah, many, many ayats, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants provision to those that He wills with no count. With no count. There is no limit to the risk that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth and created everything. Allah can give rizq with no count. So it is only given if I feel that, why is my car 30 years old and everybody else their cars is 20 years old? Actually, think of that. There are some people that if they are given granted more, it will actually not be a benefit for them. What is the definition of rizq? Sadly, many people, maybe even the majority of people, think rizq is money. Money or bigger house that we have, or the car that we have. Let us define what rizq in Sharia, in Islam. What does rizq mean? Rizq is what will be of benefit in the immediate or later, عاجلاً أو آجلاً. Rizq is whatever will benefit me now or a little bit later. What does a little bit later mean? Next year, in 10 years. Or later means the big one, in the day of judgment. Oh, so rizq can benefit me. There is types of rizq that will benefit me in dunya and will benefit me also in the hereafter. And rizq can, whether a person gets it through halal means or haram means, it is still considered rizq. But there is another definition. There is a smaller classification of rizq, which is called rizq with blessings. Ni'mah. Ni'mah or blessings or barakah. Inshallah, many of us know the word barakah. Barakah will not come from a rizq that is achieved by haram means. Barakah, which we all want. Baraka, which we desperately all need. Baraka is when you buy something and it lasts and it lasts and it lasts and it lasts and nothing goes wrong with it. And you buy another car and every day, another one, if there is no baraka, you buy a car and every day there is a problem with it. And you take it to the garage and you say, this is broken. You're spending more money. It's going to the garage and coming out from the garage. Or you have a family and there is something that happens to them that requires a person to spend a fair amount of money going around to surgeons and we can't find a cure for this or tablets, right, left, and so on and so forth. This is lack of barakah. If we want barakah, so barakah is, the risk is this much. Barakah is a part of risk. If we want barakah, that risk must be halal. If it is not halal, there will be no barakah. طيب. People are divided into four groups as far as rizq is concerned. And it is really very important for us to contemplate about which group each one of us belong to. Inshallah, none of us is for the first group. The first group do not recognize rizq. What is rizq? I have nothing, because you're only considering money. I have nothing, I don't have anything. There is no risk for me, he doesn't recognize the risk. He will only, that type of person, that first group, will only recognize risk when he loses it. Meaning what? His liver was perfectly okay, but when the liver dysfunctions, he says, oh, what a shame. Now he realizes the benefit of his liver. He has eyesight. He does not recognize that as a rizq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does not recognize it as a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he begins to have problems with his eyes, he can't see, where is the glasses or something like that. He says, oh, it was really nice. So the first group does not recognize the rizq except when he loses that rizq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make none of us is like that. The second type of people recognize rizq. They understand what is rizq. That rizq is a variety of things, including money and so on and so forth. They recognize that, but they do not see it as coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do we have an example of that? Yes, Fir'aun. Fir'aun had tremendous amount of money, power, palaces, gold, everything, but he did not recognize that this is Qarun. Qarun is one of the richest people that existed in history. What did he say? Quran testifies in Surah Al-Qasas. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوْتِيتُهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. No. I am a clever man. I got it because I'm a clever man. I know how to buy and sell. I know how to make things, whatever. I'm a clever guy. I'm intelligent. I got it because of my ability. So that's the second type of people. They recognize rizq. He's recognizing that he has wealth and he has power and so on and so forth. He does not acknowledge that the source of that rizq is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He thinks it's because he is clever. The third type of person recognizes rizq. And here now, third and fourth, we may fall in between these three and four. The third person recognizes rizq and recognizes it is from Allah. And recognize that no one can help him other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen carefully. But he's too busy with his rizq that he doesn't have time to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or doesn't have time to thank Allah as he should. Is the point clear? He recognizes that what I have is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But his rizq, whether it is tijara, whether it is buying and selling, whether it is academic advancement or whatever, research paper, whatever, PhD, doing it or master's degree, he is totally and 100% absorbed in it and does not have any time to thank Allah for giving him the brain and the ability to do what he's doing. And the fourth person, may Allah make me and you amongst the four. He recognizes rizq. He understands this eyesight is rizq. This health is rizq. The air that I breathe is rizq. The water that I drink is rizq. Have £1 million in the bank, but you don't have a drop of water to drink. What benefit will it be? Zilt. Have all the wealth in the world. Have the biggest palace. Wonderful pieces of furniture. He has a huge palace, but there is no food to eat. What good is the palace for him? A person recognizes the types of rizq, air, oxygen. There is no oxygen. Does any one of us fabricate oxygen? Does any one of us fill this room with oxygen for us to breathe? It's only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does any one of us control the sky to allow water to come? It's only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the fourth person recognizes rizq, recognizes it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and takes time out. And he seeks rizq, he works, he's not a hermit. He's not required to sit in the mosque 24 hours. He works and studies and goes and does PhDs and does MAs and does all of these things. But when it is time for prayer, he drops everything and he thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he should be thanked. Also, he uses his rizq, which is his health, his intellect, whatever Allah has granted him, to spread the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yibqa rizq is a many, many things. Our intellect is rizq. Our intelligence is rizq. The wisdom that a person has is rizq. The health that a person has is rizq. The strength of a person has is rizq. The ability to communicate is rizq. And I will be asked, the person who has a communication skills, he will be asked, how did you use that? How did you use that? Did you use it to in the service of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you used it for other means? Money is rizq, definitely. Everybody knows that money is rizq. Children is rizq. Family is rizq. Friends is rizq. Friends is rizq. Shall I say that 600 times? Suhbah is a company is rizq, because a good company will encourage me to do the right thing, and a bad company will encourage me to do the opposite. Children is rizq. Health is rizq. And you know the biggest and most important rizq? Iman. Iman is rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if he willed it, Nobody, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed the whole of you, the whole of humanity will be believers, but yet he selected a group of them. You brothers, each one of you is selected. You will become a believer inshallah. So, وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا كُلٌّ فِي كِتَابٍ مُبِينٍ. There is not a thing that moves on earth except its rizq is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As in the lovely story that somebody noticed that he's sitting down and he noticed that a little cat came and snatched a piece of meat and ran away. And he said, I wanted to know, did the little cat, this is just a story, not a hadith. What did the little cat want to take this piece of meat and feed it to his chick? So he followed the cat and he followed the cat through and he found that the cat went to a little hole in outside like that. This is in the older times, of course. And the cat dropped the piece of meat that she snatched and screamed or made some noise. And he watched, what is in that hole? And a snake came out from that hole. And he says the snake was blind. The snake sniffed because it can't see anything until it reached the piece of meat, grabbed the piece of meat in his mouth, and then went back into that little hole. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. That blind snake, because it is blind, it cannot go out and seek its rizq. Allah sends rizq for her via a cat. Via a cat. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. طيب, صلى الله عليه وسلم, one day he asked the Sahaba to come forward and come close to them. It's a long hadith, inshallah. I'll try to say abbreviated, inshallah. And then he said to them, Jibreel alayhi salam inspired me in my heart with the following meaning. إِنَّهُ لَا تَمُوتُ نَفْسٌ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا. No soul will die, rephrase, no soul will be allowed to die. There is not a single soul will be allowed to die until all the rizq that is written for it, it has taken. So you can't say, oh, I'm going to die now. You can't. You're not allowed. There is still five pounds of meat that you need to eat and da-da-da-da-da and extra cubes of oxygen that you need to inhale. You are not allowed to die until you complete your rizq. وَإِنْ حَتَّى تَسْتَكْمِلَ رِزْقَهَا وَإِنْ أَبْطَعَ عَلَيْهَا. But sometimes it appears to us, and this is a very subtle point now, sometimes it appears to us as the rizq is delayed. I want it now. I really want to change my car now, but I don't have the money. So, I'm patient for next month, and I'm patient for the month after. I still want to change my car. I really want to change my car. Where is the rizq? Where is my rizq? Where is my money so I can change the car? So at that point, you'll find people separate into two. Some people will continue to be patient, and their halal rizq will come. Others will say, oh, I've waited 3 months and now I've got to change the car. He would seek it through haram means, and it becomes a curse on him. And it stops the halal rizq. Listen to what Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. وَإِنْ أَبْطَى عَلَيْهَا فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ. Seek rizq in a beautiful way. What is in a beautiful way? Seek it, but don't work it 50 hours in 24 hours. Seek it, work. Work hard, do what is right. But nobody controls the rizq for you except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَجْمِلُوا فِي الطَّلَبِ وَلَا يَحْمِلَنَّكُمْ إِسْتَبْطَاءُ الرِّزْقِ أَنْ تَأْخُذُوهُ بِمَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not allow your thinking that your rizq is delayed, that you go to haram way to get it. Because this is not the way you will get. We agreed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who gives the rizq. Yes or no? Yes, we all agree. So how can I get what Allah has by disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? I cannot get what Allah has by disobeying him. I get what Allah has by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. How do we increase our rizq? Because this is part of the title of the talk, inshallah. I will mix between dunya things and religion things, inshallah. First of all, we should be clever. We should know what industries are working. What at the time of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if you wanted to be really, really rich, be a poet. If you are a poet, you become exceptionally wealthy. Poets are not wealthy now. They are not. They are only tiny. So to get to the point, choose the right industry. The current circumstances, the best industry is IT. IT is the best industry. If you wanted to have a good living and a good standard of living, and there's nothing wrong with that at all, if you want to have good risk, learn IT. Anything can be learned. Learn the project management. Be in medicine. Medicine will always expand because we are all getting old, and as we are getting older and as our expectation is getting bigger and bigger, people would want to be looked after, and there will be a need for people working in the medical profession. You don't have to be a doctor, but you need to be in the medical. Construction full of waste. There is tremendous opportunity to make money there. Understand that the world is very competitive. So you need to excel in what you are doing. Don't be lazy. It's not right that a person is lazy and say, oh, it's okay, I don't know it very well. No, whatever box you are in, whatever specialism you are in, know it well. When was the last time that you've read a book? Even if reading is not your thing, when was the last time that you enrolled in a program for self-development? There are many videos, there are books, even if you don't like reading books. There is many channels in YouTube that they would say you just audio books. You don't even need to pay for it. It is free. But you have to be engaged always in self-development. You are improving all the time and learning all the time. Let me say something about our religion that will help. وَلَا إِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Ya Allah, such a simple thing. Such a simple thing. Conditional statement. If you thank me, Allah is saying, if you thank me, I will give you more. So as a means of increasing our rizq, thank Allah. How do I thank Allah? Thank Allah by doing what Allah commanded us, abstain from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us not to do. And when it is time for prayer, drop everything and go to prayer, and don't favor dunya over the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not favor dunya over the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shall I say this 1,000,000 times? And use your talent in spreading the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That will be a high form, of course, inshallah. Read biographies of successful people. This is, as I mentioned many times, the people who are interested to become champions, Wimbledon champions, what do? They get the others and they read even what they eat. And they follow the same path. If you follow the same path, you want to be a successful surgeon, find out how a successful surgeon. You want to be a successful merchant, find out what they've done to be successful. And follow the same path, but always seeking what is halal. Woke up and early in the morning and pray Fajr. من صلى الفجر فهو في ذمة الله. Whoever prays Fajr, he is in the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how many times do we try to get something, to understand something, and it's like a lock, we cannot get it. And then one day, oh subhanallah, why we didn't understand this? Yeah, we didn't understand it because it is, even that is a rizq. فَفَحَّمْنَاهَا سُلَيْمَانِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired Sulaiman, granted Sulaiman the ability to understand. So even that is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always we have believed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who controls our rizq. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. And in the heavens is your rizq, not here. Here is a necessary exercise to get what is there. I can't sleep. I can't get up at 12 o'clock in the afternoon and say, inshallah, I'll pass my exam. No, you are living in cloud cuckoo land. You need to get up in the morning early and to study and study and study. And you need to get up early in the morning and work. But it's all about a balance. Time for prayer, leave it. Okay, I don't need to repeat the point again. Another reason, another factor that will increase our risk, guess what? Istighfar, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. If I say that, I get risk. Yeah, many ayahs in the Quran, I will share one of them. In Surah Hud, وَيَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. Oh my people, seek Allah's forgiveness and have tawbah, What will happen if I do that? يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا. Allah will allow rain to come. And we all agreed that without rain, nothing is worth it. ويزدكم قوة إلى قوتكم. And he will make you even stronger than your strength. In other words, Allah will give you rizq. Another way of increasing my rizq, if I want to increase my rizq, المتابعة بين الحج والعمرة. Going to Umrah and going to Hajj. I'm spending money to go to Umrah. 5,000 pounds, six, whatever. I spend the money. Yeah, if you spend that money, it will come back and many, many times more. If you go to Umrah and Hajj, listen to Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة. Frequently go and Hajj and Umrah. فإنهما ينفيان الفقر والذنوب. They destroy poverty. They destroy poverty and sins. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And one of the best ways to increase your rizq is to spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. Whatever you spend for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will grant you many times more, inshallah. أقول قول هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم استغفرونه والغفور. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وأنكحوا الأيام منكم والصالحين من عبادكم وإمائكم إن يكونوا فقراء يغنيهم الله من فضله والله واسع عليم. You'll be very surprised. If you want to increase your rizq, including money, guess what else can you do? Marry. Allah is saying, if you marry, even if the person that you marry is poor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase your rizq. طيب, inshallah. I want to share with you very quickly, we've run out of time, about the current circumstances for the Ukraine war and cost of living and what have you. It is related to rizq. Because one of the aims of the war is for the United States to destroy the Russian economy and then divide Russia into small little pieces. The majority of people also expected that 2023, there could be a deep recession. We don't know whether that is the case or not. What is the relevance to this here, to what we're talking about? Be careful about the money that you spend. Now is not the time, actually, to change your car to a more to the latest car. Sit tight, inshallah. It's not the time. If you have a son or something like that, or a daughter that gets married, instead of you going out and buying a house, try to convert a room that you have for your son. Be careful about what you spend at the moment, because we don't know what will happen by the 2023, whether there will be a depression or something like that. Okay? And also, the United States is having great difficulty. Their economy is the end. We are all now witnessing the end of the American empire. But it will take, how long will it take for it to drop down? Allah knows. But one of the aims, again, as analysts say, that the United States, it is no longer number one in the world. And deliberately, they are trying to suppress down the European economy. For instance, we know that they are selling gas to Germany at a higher rate than the market. What is the purpose of doing that, other than actually to reduce the economic power of Germany? There can be no other explanation than this. So in other words, the United States, they know themselves that they are not number one, but I am not going to allow the others, the competitors, to surpass me. What I'm going to do is I'll push them down so I remain superficially number one, inshallah. Despite all what I've said and the possible problems about economic outlook, for that reason, you need to qualify. You need to train and get to be extremely efficient in whatever you are doing. Whatever you are doing, get training and get qualifications in it. Become proficient, because competition will become fierce. So there will be 10 people applying for 5 jobs, they will take the best of 5. Try to be among those, inshallah. Now is the time to study and learn and get better. So that if it does hit, alhamdulillah, you are qualified. If it doesn't, you're still winning, inshallah. Having said all of that, always remember that rizq is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوَعَدُونَ. As I said earlier, in Sahih Muslim, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله قال لي الله said to me أنفق أنفق عليك أو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم spend and I will spend on you. Allah said to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and he's saying this to all of us, spend and I'll spend on you. So I'm saying be careful, be economical, don't change your car, don't buy another house. If you have to refurbish your existing one, it's far better. If you need to get your son married, get him to marry in the same house, just get him a room. But all of that, still spend for the sake of Allah. Don't spend on luxury, but spend in the sake of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all, inshallah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ilman nafi'a wa qalban khashi'a wa lisanan dhakira.